65 and still beautiful. Auntie Marla, thank you for having us here. It's so good. It's so yummy. Stu munching away. Latch is enjoying that. He-Man's on a diet. Ricky's just on a diet as well. But we girls, we're not on a diet, isn't it, Latch?
He-Man's on a diet.
We girls are not on a diet. We eat everything. It was so good.
Timala, your food is blessed. Your food is blessed. Look, clean plate.
To choose one sentence between you that describes this lady, yeah? Maybe even a word, because you've got 30 tables to go through. But you guys can work out one sentence or a word that describes this beautiful lady. And when we come around to you, we'll get your representative to deliver that message, okay? But what can we say about this lady that we all know? Can we have some silence, perhaps? What can we say about this lovely lady? I mean, she asked me to say a few words, which of course I'm happy to do, but I thought, you know, who could say better than the people that she loves, the special people that she invited here today?
Lots of friends. Mark, you've chosen the friends you want, family. Thank you. You're all hearing great things about my mom, and I don't think you guys have heard the plates that have been thrown at us, the brushes, the cursing, the slaps, the swearing, wrong. A mat that we used to have at home, we used to brush that mat with the special comb, we kept eating. My mom is an amazing woman. She's been through from the bottom to the top to the middle, up and down, in and out, and she always comes out smiling. I would say me and my sister are very lucky. We've been friends, we're a strong woman. And we are very, very proud of you, mom. We love you so much. There's been days when me and my sister couldn't have even gone to school because we didn't have money to go to school for lunch. And my mom would do not one, not two, not three, four jobs just to make sure that we had everything that we possibly ever needed. And up to today, she still makes that happen for us. But today we stand here and tell you, now is our turn, we've got you, mom.
But I'd like to call up Jade and Amber to make their speech towards their mommy.
On this occasion, I want to take a moment to honour this well-kind person that our mother Auntie is. Now you have the heart and soul of our family, and there are not enough words, let alone the correct ones, to even begin to express your uniqueness. Your strength, kindness and wisdom have shaped us in ways that we cannot even measure. After all the challenges life has thrown at you, your fierce spirit continues to bring a spark that lights up our life. Being raised by you, you taught us the importance of love, laughter and simple joys in life without having much. For those of you who know my mom, you will know she is the embodiment of authenticity and straightforwardness. She has a sharp sense of humour and unfiltered honesty that keeps us all on our toes, yet we wouldn't have it any other way. We haven't had the easiest of relationships, and we do butt heads sometimes, but I can just see it as a sign of the same strong mind that you do. Uncle Anne would be extremely proud of how you paved your own path, proving that strength and grace go hand in hand. And I know that he would not say, yes, it is grace, just how he will love you. Thank you for being unapologetically you. As we celebrate you today, know that you are deeply loved and appreciated. Here's to many more wonderful years of joy, happiness, and health. We love you.
This lady doesn't let anyone get to her. Nobody. And all I can say is I always go back and I said, I can't wait to see her again. Or who's gonna get ripped, right? So, with all the sweater and all that, happy birthday. Thank you for having us.
You know us, we fight. But we fight because we clash. We clash because we're so similar. And for me, that's not a bad thing. Because as everyone said so far, she's a warrior. She is someone that you can go to at your lowest, your highest, your best, your worst. She's there for you, no matter what. You know, she always says to me, I'll call her, and I'll be like, Mom, oh my God, I'm feeling irritated. And man, it's about time you're getting your own medicine. I'm like, thanks for the help, Mom, thanks for the advice, I appreciate it. But
she was Shandy.
You can go to her for advice. I'm sure
the best drink ever for
Guyanese.
Someone asked me a question, how come I know so many people? Because there's some amount of you here that I know. And everyone in this room tonight has touched me or done something for me in my life. I've got a story for more or less everyone in this room. Sometimes when I tell a story, people look at me and think, oh, she's lying. I'll give you one story. In this room, there's quite a few guys who actually were for and with me. And there was one day, we were at a job that I was managing a property. And there's a lovely young lady there with her blonde hair. Where are you? Nicolina. Yeah, so I was in front of this house and I had the boys working and this lady walked past. Don't know her. And she came up to me and she said, do you know this house is up for sale? And I said, yes, but it's under offer. And she said, if you can get me this house, I will give you £7,000. And I looked at her and I go, really? What, £7,000? And she thought I meant that the money wasn't enough. So I was like in shock that she didn't give me £7,000. And I repeated, well, you're going to give me £7,000 if I get you this house. She said, so are you happy for £10,000? And I said to her, well, £10,000 you're going to give me for this house. And she said, yes. She said, look, let's have a deal at £12,000 for the house. And I put my hand out and I went, all right. And she gave me her number and she left. And the family was living in Italy. Who owned the house. I phoned up and I went, Christine, I've got cash prior from the house. And Christine phoned and the other lady. And anyway, in the end, Nicolina's got the house. And no, Nicolina got the house. And on the day that she signed and got the keys for the house, Nicolina turned up at my house and transferred £12,000 in my van. And we have become friends. Not just because of the money, but I'm just telling you of how I've met certain people in my life. There's a story for everybody in here. Everybody is somehow in my friends. I want to thank Anita over there. Anita is one of my lifeline, I would say. Especially since when Riley was sick, she was there for me every single day. Same for my dear friend Sharon over there. She phones me every day. Corinne phones me every day. I got my friend, my sister Arlene. Thank you very much for making this evening. And I just want to say a few other things. How blessed I am that I'm gonna call name. But my birthday this afternoon, and this is how blessed I feel, not having you guys here. My birthday here, this whole party has been thrown by someone for me. The food, the venue and everything, I didn't have to pay for it. All the alcohol on the bar was thrown for me by someone. My dress I'm wearing, being bought for me by someone. Not the same person though, not the same person. But they're not all men, I must say. But everything that
me for tonight. And I look back at my life and I said, if I wasn't a good person and kind to so many, they would not have been doing all of this for you. So tonight, I ain't paying nothing. This is a free party, right? O'Neill, where are you? Come, O'Neill. So O'Neill has taken so much, as they say, I like the cost, because he didn't charge a pass and took out the drinks. I had to text the father this morning. He said, don't take any stress, I'm coming to get it. But my darling O'Neill is always there to help me out as well. O'Neill, thank you very, very much. And I so many best friends. And one last thing I want to say is, I'm sure I don't want to say, but I want to say that I know I lost my husband 18 months ago, but it was his dream to throw me an amazing 65th birthday. He's not here, but I am blessed I've got good friends who decided they want to throw the party for me. I missed him very much. And next month he would have been 70, so I'm going to be going to Guyana to see him for his 70th birthday. And I want to thank each and every one of you for coming, and also for all the help and support you've given me through my good times and my bad times. As my children said, I've had such bad times in my life that I could not send my children to school because I didn't have a car to pay the bus fare. That's how low I went in my life. And I'm so proud to tell you guys, because those things made me a strong person today, and a believe I am. Thank you all for coming.
Well, you have Marla and a lucky gentleman Tony to open the floor up. DJ. Tony. Luckiest guy in the building, in the world, in fact.
Thank you, nice shot.
Isn't she a natural beauty? Hey,
no matter, that makes someone shine.
If you know the words,
to breathe.
Thank you.